everyone. I'm Linda Franz, and I've printed some of the new Inklingo apple core shapes on fabric so I can show you how I sew these gentle curves by hand. You can also sew them by machine, of course. We've come a long way since acrylic templates. I used a charm pack of 5 by 5 inch swatches. I'm going to sew this little seam to join another apple core to the row. It doesn't look as if it's going to fit, does it? Here's a little tip about apple core. We're always sewing this curve to this curve. One is concave and the other is convex. That's just how they fit together. Since we're sewing these together, they have to be exactly the same curve and exactly the same length. You can draw your own apple core on freezer paper. Start with an arc and then trace it until you have this four-sided shape. It's that simple. And because it's all the same arc, these stitching lines are going to fit together, even though it doesn't look that way when you've added the seam allowances. I've already clipped the concave seam allowance. I only clip one of the seam allowances. This is explained in the instructions in the shape collection. I've used 2 shallow clips between the matches. This is better than doing 1 deeper one. It makes the sewing and the pressing work better. And clipping only takes a sec. I just stretched this to show you how shallow the clips are, but please don't stretch. It could permanently distort the piece. When I pick it up, I want the clipped side up facing me when I sew by machine. I do it the same way when I sew by hand, but you can try it with the other side up when you're sewing by hand and see if you like that better. I sew some seams by hand and some seams by machine, depending on where I am. Machine piecing gives me fast results, but hand piecing is very relaxing and portable. When I sew these curves by machine, I pin all of the matches first. Pinning can be quite enjoyable when you have the right tools, and it can give you confidence. I was thrilled when I found Karen K. Buckley's Perfect Pins. They're extremely fine and have a tiny glass head. They come in a little tube like this. I'll put a link to Karen's website below the video. I have no affiliation. I just recommend what I enjoy using myself. If you've been following me for the last 19 or 20 years, you know that in my Quilted Diamonds books and in Inklingo books, I usually only pin one match at a time when I'm sewing by hand, whether it's a straight seam or a curved seam. And sometimes I use a needle instead of a pin because I want to simplify my hand piecing sewing kit when I'm on the go. In this case, I pinned several apple cores ahead of time, so they're ready to pick up when I have a minute by hand or by machine. I recommend trying it both ways, pinning one match at a time and pinning all the matches before you start sewing. See what you like best. You can see how the pieces want to curve as soon as they are pinned. When I hand piece, there is no need to pin at the beginning. My first stitch does it. The matches are close enough together that the line between is almost a straight line, but they all add up to a curve. See how the pieces curve around my fingers? That makes it easier to load the needle with 3 or 4 stitches, fewer than I would load on a long straight seam. I take a back stitch about every half inch or so, almost every time I start a new load. I remove the pins as I go, so a finger pin cushion is perfect. I like to use a sharp needle. You might prefer a short, stiff between, or a longer, flexible straw needle. Just because I like to use a sharp doesn't mean you have to use a sharp too. It's a very personal preference. As usual, I just sew from crosshair to crosshair, not edge to edge. I finish with another backstitch. This is very relaxing, very portable. I love doing this. See how nicely the seams lie down? The clip side is underneath. Because I always want to sew with the clipped side up, I'm sewing one seam at a time. When I finish a seam, I turn everything over and sew in the other direction so that I still have the clipped side up. Since I only sew from crosshair to crosshair, when I join the rows, I can press the intersections like this. That means every intersection looks its best from the front. I think you will love sewing these curves by hand. I'll probably also do another video showing what it looks like when I sew these curves by machine. In the meantime, you can see how relaxing and enjoyable it is when you skip the templates and print the shapes on fabric with Inklingo, so you have a sewing line, matching marks, and crosshairs precisely on the fabric. I hope you'll check the links below, and it helps me if you like the video. Thank you for watching.